about initiation or translation in eukaryotes. So first of all, eukaryotic translation, that is initiation, starts from the involvement of ribosomal subunit. So here there is a ribosomal subunit which is formed by the breaking of 80S ribosome, which shows the presence of eukaryotic ribosome. So 80S ribosome breaks into two subunits, 40S and 60S. These two subunits have tendency to bind together. So for the maintenance of its separate structure, there is a factor EIF6 which binds with the 60S subunit for the separation. So when EIF6 binds with the 60S, so these two factors cannot bind and now they are separated. So 40S which come here for the association of the other factors which are involved in initiation of eukaryotic transcription. Some factors right here, factor 2 is a very important factor, factor 3, factor 4C, and initiator transfer RNA, that is methionine, attached with the methionine, with the first transfer RNA, that is initiator transfer RNA. Okay. Now, 40S ribosome subunit bind with the 4C, that is factor 4C and factor 3, and make the complex, that is 40S ribosomal complex. Okay? 40S ribosomal complex converted into 43S pre-initiation complex. This complex formation, that is the first step of the initiation. The first step for the initiation, that is the formation of 43S complex formation. Now this complex formation, that is formed by the delivery of ternary complex. This ternary complex, that is factor 2 associated with the transfer RNA, initiator transfer RNA and GTP. As you know, this factor has three subunits, alpha, beta and gamma subunit. So alpha subunit binds to the GTP and its gamma unit binds to transfer RNA, initiator transfer RNA, and its beta subunit involved in the recycling. Now this ternary complex binds and there is a formation of 43 pre-initiation complex. Now next step is the second step, attachment of messenger RNA. Messenger RNA in eukaryote, as you know previously, that is the cap at the 5 prime end and 3 prime end has poly-A-tails. That is the structure which shows that this messenger RNA present in the eukaryotes. Cap and poly-A-tail absent in prokaryotes. So this messenger RNA having the start codon AUG now attached with the 43 S pre-initiation complex. For the attachment, there is involvement of number of factors. Factor EIF4F, 4B, 4A and 4E factor which involve for the attachment of messenger RNA. So there is a moment of messenger RNA for the attachment, so there is a need of energy. So ATP hydrolyzed into ADP and one phosphate, inorganic phosphate is released. And now here 4E binds with the cap and all factor involved for the loading of this 43 subunit on the messenger RNA. Now next important structure, that is scanning. Scanning for the start codon. As you know, in prokaryotes, for the initiation there is a presence of Shine-Dalgarno sequence. That is absent here. So scanning is must for the searching of AUG, initiation codon. So this complex, 40S pre-initiation complex, bind with the messenger RNA at its 5' cap. At 5' cap end, it's bind to the messenger RNA. Now, scan the messenger RNA. After searching the AUG, there is this structure and this structure, that is the scanning of messenger RNA by 43S complex. Okay? And now, all these factors which are associated here already, binding of 60S requires the removal of all other factors. So, another factor 5, come and release all other factors except charge transfer RNA. Initiated transfer RNA. So, all other factors 2, GTP, that is hydrolysis of GTP. Here, GTP hydrolyze and factor 2 with GTP. Another factor 3, 14, 5 are all released. That is the only 40S subunit with transfer RNA. And now this, there is a again association of the last subunit, because this is the free subunit attached with the small subunit, 40S subunit, and its size, A size and B size for the further protein synthesis. So, ATS initiation complex is for, and the last subunit bind, that is the first polypeptide synthesis. There is initiation complex which involves further process for the elongation. An important thing is this cycle. EIS2 cycle is very important, and it is also involved in the regulation of initiation of translation in eukaryotes. So, how it regulates the process? So, you see here, there is the 2 GDP and here 2 GDP. So, firstly, 2 GDP and 2 GDP. This complex, factor 2 with GDP, which has less affinity with the 40S subunit. So, it is released easily from this complex. When GDP hydrolyzed, so factor 2 associated with the GDP, which has less affinity with the 40S, so it release from here. Next process. Now this factor 2 GDP, factor 2 have more affinity than the GTP. That is 400 fold higher affinity of GDP than the this factor 2 जो है आपका उसको देखेंगे regulation में आपको देखता है factor 2 have higher affinity with the GDP than the GTP. Higher it means 400 fold higher. The 400 times जो है वो ज़्यादा ये इसके साथ binding capacity है इसकी than the factor 2 with GTP. So for the formation of this factor 2 GTP, there is a requirement of another helper factor, that is called EIF2B or GEF. GEF is guanine exchange factor. So this factor, that is the cycling of factor 2. Factor 2, all these factors release, so there is a need of this factor. This factor 2 with GDP. Now this helper factor which help for the formation of factor 2 GTP. Now factor 2 complex with the GTP, and this complex this help in the attachment of transfer RNA, initiated transfer, and all in this two factor 2 and GTP involved in the delivery of initiated transfer RNA or charge transfer RNA to 40S. Now, next important thing, if any phosphorylation of subunit of alpha subunit, if there is a 3, you know that there is a 3 subunits, alpha, beta, gamma, if its alpha subunit is phosphorylated, then what happens? In phosphorylation occurs, when any infection, viral infection or yeast of condition, that is the situation for the phosphorylation of alpha subunit of factor 2. Factor 2 का अगर alpha subunit phosphorylation हो गया, then what happened in the protein synthesis? ठीक है? This phosphorylated alpha unit, it is EIF2-alpha-K. That is the phosphorylated condition of second factor. This factor have, it is this GEF have more affinity, approximately 154 more affinity with the alpha, phosphorylated subunit of alpha than the unmodified EIF. आप समझ रहे हैं कि GEF as factor which involved in the recycling, that is guanine chain factor, have more affinity with alpha phospho alpha P, it is phosphorylated alpha unit of factor 2 than the unmodified factor 2. When this bind with the this, so there is a permanent or complex structure is formed. EIF2 alpha P GBF. There is a complex formation. Is the formation of this complex, that is a strong complex form, and this complex formation prevent the formation of this two, this type. Factor 2 association with the GTP is prevented by the formation of this complex. This complex is the EIF2 alpha unit of this is phosphorylated with GDP and GEF. Simply ye ho gaya na, there is a simple unmodified GDP. Phosphorylation of alpha unit of this causes the binding of GEF, because GEF have more affinity with the modified subunit alpha unit, that is phosphorylated alpha unit, than the unmodified. So there is a permanent complex formation EIF2 FP GDP GEF, which prevent the formation of this complex. This is factor 2 with the GTP, and this complex that prevent the initiation of